Hello, Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer of metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I am going to describe how Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji was killed in Delhi. When he was asked to come to Delhi, then the Sikhs with him, some of the Sikhs were frightened because of this hostility displayed by these Khatris and Mullahs. They were very much out of control. But three of them, they accompanied Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji to Delhi. And when they reached Delhi, imprisoned in the iron cage and then imprisoned in Delhi jail, then these mullahs, who were Kashmiri Khatris, they asked Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji to convert to Islam. And Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji said, "We already preach Islam, and not this Islam of Sunnat or circumcision and of Kalma doesn't make you a Muslim but a Mohammedan." So that enraged them. They were angry at him, and because they were making Mohammedans are making Muslim by just circumcision and say reading Kalma or the confession that they, what they do in the mosque these days. So Satguru Nanak Dev Ji has defined a Muslim as a person who is a merciful person, who cleans his heart with his word. In other words, a true Muslim has been defined as a person who has conscience, is truthful, contented, and merciful. Such a Muslim, he is in Allah, Allah is in him. But these Satan, they wanted to make everyone a Muslim, and then they will spit at other people. Like Hindus, they will spit at their face or even urinate, ask them to drink. So they humiliated the people too much. So Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji then gave his head to these mullah for the atrocity they were committing. Remember that today they are reaping the reward in Kashmir. There will be no peace in Kashmir, and the end of the world is approaching. However, in Delhi, those Sikhs which were with him, they were tortured in front of Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji. One was sawn from top to bottom with a saw, wood saw. The other was boiled in hot water, and the other was, his body was chopped in small pieces, bit by bit. So all that atrocity they committed, Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji calmly watched them, because he was the omniscient. He knew what's going to happen. So on 11th November 1675, then Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji was beheaded. Now they wanted Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji to perform a miracle. Now miracles are not performed before those people who are clever. They are performed among simple-minded people who are believers. Not those who see the miracle and they will say, oh, this is nothing. As Christ Jesus never performed a miracle in Jerusalem except of the fig tree, when he showed them that temple is producing no fruit for to be taken to my father. So he destroyed the, predicted the destruction of the temple, that not one brick will stand on top of the other. So same temple is in our Amritsar, with that Bethesda Pool of Mercy is Amrit Srovar. So these Khatri mullahs then enforced the execution, and as regard the miracle was concerned, Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji wrote something on a piece of paper and tied it around his neck and told him, you know, to the man who was executor, that instead of being tortured or cut in small pieces or anything, he told him that he won't be able to cut his head when this piece of paper is tied around and the thread won't be cut. His head will go, but not this thread will be cut. So this stupid executioner, he said, oh, I can cut this head and the thread without any problem. So he gave a hard stroke, separating head from the body. So Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji did not suffer a cruel death as they do when they kill an animal and they let the blood bleed out slowly and the animal is in pain, suffering. That is not halal. It is a torture, cruelty. Halal mean the money you earn of your own hard labor. That is halal. Not that you fleece it or rob other people and gather riches as they were doing during the Mughal rule. They will rob anyone. And those who became Mohammedan, they were behaving as if they hold the government. It was only their conscience that did not let them do utter cruelty. In the villages, because some of our Jats also had become Mohammedan, so they gave us protection. They helped us. In the towns, these Khatri mullahs were protecting their own Khatri people. But they were against Jats and other village people who were hunted and their heads had a price on them. So they were killing people like sparrows without any conscience. So when this utter cruelty prevailed, then the next light was Royal King or Sache Pasha Hargobind Rai Ji. Sorry, next light was Sache Pasha Gobind Rai Ji, not Hargobind Rai Ji. So he was the last prophet on earth and I will describe in the next video.